So in this session, we are going to talk about Redis High Availability. And Redis High Availability is different than, you know, Redis Replication. In Redis Replication, what we have done is we had a master server, then we had n number of, you know, slave nodes. And whenever master goes down, you can connect to slave node to perform read-only operations. However, if you want to convert a slave node to a master node, you have to take some sort of manual action. Now, with the help of something called Redis Sentinel, this is a software which is bundled with the Redis software package. So Redis Sentinel is going to allow us, you know, or going to provide us a mechanism using which we are going to automate basically the process of making a slave node to a master node whenever the existing master node is down. So now, what is the requirement which you need to have in order to, you know, perform this Redis High Availability? So one of the key things which you need to note is that you need to install Sentinel on minimum of 3 servers. Okay, now the reason why you need 3 servers on which you need to install Redis Sentinel is that there is something called quorum. Okay, so quorum configuration basically is the minimum number of Sentinel servers which needs to agree that a master node is down, and then it is going to convert one of the slave nodes to a master node. Okay, so quorum, basically Redis Sentinel is going to have an election process, and in that election process, you know, majority of Redis Sentinels are going to decide that yes, master node is down and it is not reachable, and now this is the time they need to be promoting one of the slave nodes to a master node. Okay, so whatever, you know, number you provide in the quorum configuration, that is the minimum number of servers or Sentinel servers or Sentinel services which is going to be agreeing and going to perform this election of a new master server. The other thing to notice is that Sentinel runs on a default port of 26379. Okay, whereas Redis runs on a, you know, default port of 6379. Both of these ports can be changed from the configuration file. So if we remember, Redis configuration is stored in redis.conf file and Sentinel configuration is stored in sentinel.conf file. Now both of these files are kept at the same directory, and also there is a called redis-sentinel utility which is also stored in the same directory where redis-server utility is available. So you do not need a separate, you know, downloading and installing of this Sentinel software. It comes bundled with the same software. The only thing is you need to start the services after doing the correct configuration. Now let's discuss about the working of these nodes. So now this Redis Sentinel, we are saying that we need to install it on minimum of 3 nodes. But those nodes do not need to be a completely separate server. Okay, that can be a same Redis server on which you can install Redis Sentinels. So in this example, you can see we have a master node and then we have 2 slave nodes, which is S1 and S2. Okay, and then we have Redis Sentinel 1 which is running on master node, then we have Redis Sentinel 2 which is running on slave node 1, and then we have Redis Sentinel 3 which is running on slave node 2. Okay, and in this case, whenever master is going to, you know, get down, in that case you can see Redis Sentinel are going to decide that it is the time they need to elect and promote one of the slave nodes to a master, and in this case they have promoted slave node to a master node. Okay, and also when one of the slave nodes is converted to a master node, all the previous or any previous master node is going to be automatically changed to a slave node. So whenever this master node, which is M1, comes back, this is actually going to become a slave node. Okay, and this is going to become a slave node of this server, newly elected master server. So both of these are basically a slave node of this master server. Now there is something called down after milliseconds parameter, okay, which you see here, and this is the configuration which is done in sentinel.conf file. So down after milliseconds number tells Sentinel that this is the number of, you know, milliseconds Sentinel should wait after master is not able to reach. Okay, so whatever number you define here, that is the minimum number of time Sentinel is going to wait for master to come back up. If master is not able to connect for that number of time, then it is just going to start the election of a new master process. In our example, we are going to, you know, discuss about the same scenario. We are going to have three servers on which we are going to make the same setup, and we will see how all of these works. Okay. So now let's discuss about what are the different, you know, kind of setup which you can have, and what are the, you know, some of the advantages or disadvantages of all of those kind of scenarios. Let's try to see what are the issues which we can have and what is the mitigation. Now the first deployment type which is shown here is a deployment where we have only two Redis Sentinel running, Redis Sentinel 1 and Redis Sentinel 2. So this is the deployment which you should never do. It is never going to work. The reason being is because quorum is set to 2, and whenever this, you know, whenever, let's say we have a problem with this server, and in that case M1 and RS1, both these services are going to get impacted, both of these will not be available. So now Redis Sentinel 2 doesn't have the minimum number of Redis Sentinels available, you know, to perform the election process and convert this slave node to a master node. So that's the reason it is recommended that you never do this deployment. Okay, the only way when this setup is going to work is when there is, you know, the server on which Redis Sentinel 1 is running, okay, that server somehow is available and Redis Sentinel 1 is also available, and there is some impact only on the Redis master node. Let's say for some reason Redis master node, you know, service is not running, but that server is available and Redis Sentinel 1 is running and Redis Sentinel 2 is also running. That is the only scenario in which it is going to work, because in that case Redis Sentinel 1 and Redis Sentinel 2 are going to agree that yes, master is down, and it is going to promote slave to master node. Okay, because quorum is set to 2, and that's why if Redis Sentinel 1 and Redis Sentinel 2 both are available, then this process can work. However, in production, usually we know that, you know, this is very unlikely that you are going to have problem only with Redis and you are not going to have problem with Redis Sentinel whenever there is any problem on that server. Okay, so that's the reason this is the setup which is not recommended. Now let's discuss about another deployment. So in this deployment we have three Sentinels. We have a master and we have two replicas. And here quorum is set to 2. And this is a good approach if you have minimum of 3 servers. Okay, so when you have minimum of 3 servers, all you can do is you can set up one Redis Sentinel on each of the servers, and one of the server can become Redis master and remaining two servers are going to be slave 1 and slave 2. So in this case, whenever one node goes down, as we have seen, that in that case the other node is going to become master node. So let's say M1 was down and this is going to become a master node. However, let's say for some reason, you know, this master is in a different subnet and slave 1 and slave 2 is in a different subnet. Let's say IP of this begins with something like 10.0, dot 0 dot star, and then these two slave nodes are from a different subnet. So it starts with, let's say, something dot from 10 dot 4 dot 0 dot star. And you know, for some reason you have issue between this subnet connecting to this subnet. Okay, so in this case what is going to happen is basically Redis Sentinel, you know, whole of this block or set of users, you know, are not going to be able to connect to master node, even though, you know, the actual service or on the server is still up and running. Okay, in fact Redis Sentinel 1 is also running and Redis is also running on this server. However, since there is a network issue and network partition between, you know, this between this subnet and this subnet, so Redis Sentinel 2 and Redis Sentinel 3 is basically going to agree that yes, they are not able to reach master, so they are going to convert this, you know, slave, one of the slaves, to a master, and then the other remaining, you know, previous master node is going to be turned into a slave node whenever that is available and going to join this network. So in this scenario, basically, let's say if we have a user which is user A, it is connected to, you know, directly to master node. So whenever it is performing all the write operation, that is going to be, you know, so since this master node is still a master node, it is going to allow all the write operations. But whenever, you know, this issue is resolved and all of these networks are able to connect to each other, this, since this master, you know, state has been changed to a slave node by Sentinel, so whenever it joins back the network, this M1 is going to be a slave of this new master, and whatever data which has been written by user A is going to get lost. Okay, because this slave will be trying to become in the same state which this new master is. However, this issue does have a mitigation. So there is something called minimum replicas to write configuration, which you can set to 1 in this case. So whenever you have a scenario like this, in this case, if user A is writing data to master, master will not be having any slaves. Okay, it will not be having any slaves to write or replicate its data to. And since we have set minimum replicas to write is 1, so master must have at least or minimum of 1 replicas where it needs to replicate its data to. And if it is not able to find that 1 replica, it is not going to allow any write operation. So user A, whenever it is trying to perform write operation, it is going to get error, and this is how user A is going to get aware that yes, there is some issue which is going on with the Redis server. However, user A still can successfully perform all the read operations. Now once you do this mitigation, there is again one more, you know, downback, or one more drawback is basically that whenever both of the replicas are down, the master is not going to accept writes. Okay, so let's say when we have issue with S1 and S2 and both of them are not available, in that case master server is not going to allow any write operation. The reason being is because minimum replicas is set to 1. So again, whenever you are doing a, you know, setup in your production environment, you can assess these scenarios that do you going to face any, you know, problem which can occur because of network partition. Probably you can try to make all the, you know, Redis nodes part of the same network partition. Again, you know, different kind of issues can produce a different behavior. So always it is best you do a good testing before deploying your application in a production environment. Now let's discuss about another scenario. In this scenario, we have only 2 servers available for Redis. Okay, so we have made 1 Redis server to a master node, and then we have converted 1 Redis server to a slave node. Now in this scenario, you see we have not installed Redis Sentinel on Redis server. So rather what is done here is, you know, there are set of three servers where application server or application is running. On those nodes, Redis Sentinels are installed. Okay, and these Redis Sentinels are still going to monitor master and slave nodes and going to work the same way which we have seen in this example. Now the issue which can come here is when you have, you know, this application server is totally disconnected with this master and slave node. So let's say for some reason when, you know, all of these is completely disconnected with master and slave, in that case you are going to have issues. And also for some reason, let's say if there is no connectivity between this application server and master server, then you won't be able to set up basically this kind of setup. Now let's discuss about another, you know, deployment scenario. In this scenario, it is assumed that on the application side also you have only two servers available. Okay, so when I'm saying application side, so basically this can be the servers where you have your, let's say, web application running or any application running which is going to connect to the Redis database. So in this case, we see we have only two servers available for applications and two servers are available for Redis database. So in this case, we have installed four sentinels. Okay, so we have one sentinel which is installed on application server. And then we have Redis Sentinel 2 which is also installed on application server. Then we have Redis Sentinel 3 which is installed on the same server where currently Redis Master is installed. And then we have Redis server or Redis Sentinel 4 which is installed on the same server where Slave 1 is installed. And in this case now, since we have 4 sentinels available, so that's why minimum number of sentinels which needs to be agreed is set to 1. Which is set to 3. So you can see here quorum is set to 3. And this is also a good approach if you have minimum of 3 servers including your client server and Redis server. So client, by client server what I mean here is the application server. So basically you need to achieve is that you need to have minimum of 3 servers available to install your Redis Sentinel. You know, that is the precisely basically we are trying to say in all of the scenarios. Okay, in none of the scenarios we have seen a, you know, perfectly fine working model where we have less than 3 sentinels available. So that's it about Redis, you know, high availability and sentinel deployment. In next session we are going to do a hands-on session where we are going to set up 3 servers, and on those servers we are going to set up a high availability using Sentinels.